has got more.
Scotland, England, battle royal, only this time with a world crown at stake. Alex Arthur and Nicky Cook could take an old rivalry to a new level.
I'm here to win, you know, I'm here to look sensational, and, you know, I'm really up for the fight. Preparations went great, Craig, so no excuses now, just looking forward to getting on with it, really.
Obviously, I'm confident. I won't be taking no fight like it otherwise, and I'm confident in the weight. Now I'm making the weight a lot easier, kind of stepping up to super feather. And now I'm just really excited and looking forward to the fight and the opportunity to fight for a world title once again.
The self-styled Amazing Alex Arthur's a career super featherweight.
Knockout! Amazing Alex Arthur!
Good size and power way in his favour.
We'll see once we get in the ring, you know. It might play a part, it might not. You know, I'm hoping that on the night I'm much stronger than Nicky, yeah.
In trainer Wayne McCulloch, he's enlisted an ex-world champion to iron out defensive faults.
I joke with people to say I taught him how to have a good chin. My little secret weapon.
You teach that? Can you teach that?
Oh, you can teach it. There's a certain way to teach it. There's a way of doing certain, you know, movements to avoid the big shot.
But trained by his own father, Cook thinks differently.
I mean, you've looked at the Gomez fight, obviously. You still think he's got defensive frailties there?
Well, you know, everyone needs to tighten up, and every boxer still learning until the day they retire. And there's no doubt with me, no doubt with Alex.
A triple title holder at featherweight, could a move up to 9'4" now deliver the one belt he craves?
At 9 stone, I was beginning to really struggle. European level, Commonwealth level, British level, I was getting away with it. But at world level, you've got to have the whole package. When I win this title, it's going to mean a lot to me.
The fight of the night, no question?
Oh, I don't think so. Most definitely, yeah.
Both fighters are ready behind the scenes. Nicky Piper, this is one that could be the fight of the night, couldn't it?
Really, really good fight. Two very closely matched boxers. Very, very skillful, both of them. Arthur may be the bigger puncher. I worry about his stamina. Cook with body shots could come into it later. It's going to be really, really close.
Glenn, what's going to happen here?
You know, I fancy Nicky Cook more and more. I really think his confidence at that extra weight, he's going to do it. I think he can win.
Instinct tells me to go with Cook. Common sense tells me to go with Arthur.
Okay, this world title fight is up next. Who will win the Battle of Britain?
Sensational stuff. What a fight. Great hands from Alex Arthur. Look at this. Arthur piles on the pressure.
Knockout. Amazing Alex Arthur. And this one rocked him a bit. Stiffened his legs.
This is good stuff from Nicky Cook. That's a good record.
It's a spectacular triumph that for Nicky Cook.
The fabulous M.E.N. Arena here in Manchester, filling up rapidly ahead of Amir Khan's big night. First world title fight of the evening coming next. Alex Arthur, Nicky Cook, our MC is Mark Burdis.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the WBO Super Featherweight Championship of the World. Manchester, are you ready? It's time to begin. Please welcome into the ring the challenger, Nicky Cook.
Well, Nicky Cook, supremely confident as he moves up in weight to fight defending champion Alex Arthur here tonight in this Anglo-Scottish battle. Cook, who's from Dagenham and who's been trained all his career by his father, Paul. He says the extra poundage in moving up suits him down to the ground because he really killed himself to make featherweight, and he was very well beaten when he challenged for the world title at that weight against a very good American called Steve Luavano 14 months ago. Tonight, he says, it's all going to be different. He's dangerous with the left hook to the body, isn't he, this guy?
Yeah, he's got it in every department. He can box, he can fight, he can have a tear up, he can punch to the body, switch to the head. I fancy him, he's a class operator. I fancy him to win a title at featherweight. He came up a little bit short. I'm just wondering, is that fight long enough in the history? He's only had one little non-time job since then. Has this come too soon for him?
Alex Arthur's on his way from the dressing room. We heard him earlier, predicting that this would be the fight of the night. He's always called himself that amazing Alex Arthur ever since he won a Commonwealth Games gold medal.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome into the ring the WBO super featherweight champion of the world, the amazing Alex Arthur!
It's hard to believe, really, because we can remember him when he was just a teenager, but he's 30 now, Alex Arthur. He was handed the WBO Super Featherweight Championship of the World in the boardroom because the guy he was supposed to fight for the vacant title, Joanne Guzman, could not make the weight. So they gave Arthur the championship. Now he has to prove tonight he really is world championship material.
Yeah, well, there's a short list of fighters who have been world champion but never won a world title fight. Alex Arthur will not want to be on that list, and he doesn't deserve to be on it because he's a class operator. This is his world title fight tonight. He can't afford to lose. He'll get over it. He's shown tremendous spirit in many of his fights in the past. He's going to need that tonight, but I'm sure we'll see it.
Remember too that Lennox Lewis was handed his world title initially too. He wasn't half bad in the end, was he?
Exactly.
By the way, there's some talk. Look at this, a bit of needle and feeling between the two fighters. A bit of talk that Arthur might be a future Amir Khan opponent. That's down the road. Here's what the vital statistics say tonight. Arthur 2 years older at 30. He's naturally the bigger man. He has a height advantage, a reach advantage. They both made the 9 stone 4 pounds limit. Arthur a bit easier than he did for his last fight against Steve Foster, it should be said. Arthur's been a pro now for 8 years and Cook for 10 years. Very similar records they've got, both with just one defeat on the record. Almost an identical number of rounds too. Good fight this should be.
Ladies and gentlemen, Frank Warren in association with www.frankwarren.tv and sponsored by Oxota presents the co-main event of the evening. 12 3-minute rounds for the WBO Super Featherweight Championship of the World, live and exclusive on Sky Box Office here at the M.E.N. Arena in Manchester. Your officials are appointed by the World Boxing Organization and the British Boxing Board of Control. And your three scoring judges at ringside are from Birmingham, Mr. Terry O'Connor, Mr. Dave Paris from Leeds, and from Rochester, Kent, Mr. Roy Francis, all the judges from England. Your WBO supervisor is Mr. Arthur Ellison of Germany. Your steward in charge is Mr. Charles Giles. And when the action begins, your referee is Mr. Mickey Van of Leeds, England. Your timekeeper at the bell is Mr. Barry Pinder. And now, to introduce the contestants. Firstly, the challenger from Dagenham, England, weighing in at 9 stone, 3 pounds, 8 ounces, and fighting out of the red corner, wearing the blue shorts, entering the ring with just one blemish in 28 fights, with 16 stoppages, wins to his name. He's the former undefeated British, Commonwealth, and European champion, and a former world title challenger. Tonight, he challenges for his second world championship, this time at Super Featherweight. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting and introducing the challenger for the title, Nicky Cook! And across the ring stands the champion, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the blue and white shorts, and weighing in at 9 stone 4. He brings with him a record of 26 wins and just one loss with 19 KOs. As an amateur, he won silver at the 1998 Commonwealth Games, and as a professional, he has captured British, Commonwealth, and European titles. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome from Edinburgh in Scotland, making the first defense of his title, the reigning WBO Super Featherweight Champion of the World, the amazing Alex Arthur! Your referee will now give his final instructions to both boxers.
Mickey Van is that referee.
Instructions in the dressing room. Obey my commands at all times. I want no noughties with the head. Shake hands, buddy corners. Good luck, fellas.
Ladies and gentlemen, 12 three-minute rounds for the WBO Super Featherweight Championship of the World.
Well, is Alex Arthur going to be too big for Nicky Cook? And how much did that damaging world title defeat against Steve Lovano, how much of a dent has that left in Cook? Or has he recovered, and is this his best weight now? Very focused, looked really good, I thought, at the weigh-in, Cook. He's the one in the lighter blue shorts. Nicky Cook from Dagenham in Essex. It's an Anglo-Scottish battle, the radiant blue of Alex Arthur, whose only career defeat was another damaging one 5 years ago against Michael Gomez in a thriller in Edinburgh. He was well beaten that night, Arthur, and exposed a bit, but he's improved a lot since then.
Yeah, that's the thing, they both suffered a heavy defeat. Arthur's had a long time, a lot of good performance, to erase the memory. Nicky Cook hasn't had that, so I'm just wondering, did he need a few more fights before he stepped back up to world level? We shall see, but he has boxed at super featherweight before a couple of times, remember.
Alex Arthur has been trained for this fight, for the final stages anyway, by Northern Ireland's former world bantamweight champion, Wayne McCulloch. Good to see him over here from Las Vegas with his family. He says Arthur is going to hit too hard for Cook.
Well, he is the naturally bigger man, probably the more powerful puncher of the two. Cook throwing fast jabs at the moment, but not quite finding the range as yet. But he looks confident, and he is, remember, he is a big featherweight himself. So the super featherweight limit may suit him better. He may be a better fighter at this weight.
Good work there from a confident-looking Nicky Cook, who says that Alex Arthur is a bully. He's going to find out for the first time he's in with somebody who's stronger than him. Let's see. People in the boxing business have been looking forward to this one, haven't they, Jim?
Yeah, it's a cracking match. I mean, we have two men who have held British, Commonwealth and European titles one weight apart and really dominated the domestic scene, so they both are genuine world-class performers. And what a great match it is. Both, I will also say, at their peak.
Good right hand, Cook. Picked a hole there in Arthur's defence. His glove was down, he was off balance, and Cook pounced with his right.
Cook just maybe been a little bit more workmanlike in the opening round. Just finding the target after a little bit wild with his punches, looking for power, whereas Cook is looking for accuracy.
He's a good technician, Nicky Cook. Paid his dues in this business, British, Commonwealth, European champion on the way through. Can he become a world champion tonight? Cook in the lighter blue, remember. Alex Arthur with his name written helpfully for you right across his shorts. Cook's had just the better of it, hasn't he, in this opening round?
I think so, yep. He's been a bit more accurate, a little bit busier, hasn't been phased, and no sense that strength or weight is going to be an issue, but remember, it is early days.
Could be good, spoiling up already. Here's the second round. One problem Nicky Cook has in his career is he's had problems with injuries to his right hand, and sometimes he's almost had to fight one-handed with the left. Just look for signs of that tonight, how sparing he might be with that right hand.
That was a good solid jab from Arthur. Made Cook blink. I don't think he liked that. Caught him solidly. That was almost as good as the full-blown left hook. Good shot.
Looking to dig a left hand in and to the body there, Arthur. He just looks a little more controlled about his work in this second round so far.
See, I think of the two, Arthur is more equipped to take a shot, to land a shot. So if this turns into a shootout, maybe Arthur will have the advantage in early stages, but Cook was the one who was looking to clinch up close there. So these are the little signs you look for early when someone's stepping up into a new division.
It's one of those fights, this, that potentially might be thrilling and close. Good work that by Cook. Cook. I think he might make a target of the body. He felt that when Michael Gomez beat Arthur, he had good success to the body that night.
Yeah, and he has a natural body puncher too. It's not something they would have to work on from scratch in the gym. He is naturally a good body puncher.
Arthur's made the weight much easier this time. Last time out, he lost 8 pounds in the week of the fight, he says, against Steve Foster, and got decked in the 11th round badly in that fight. It wasn't too impressive. That was a bit of a worry for him.
A little bit of messing about up close, and Cook is the guilty party, but he's quite right to do it. He's getting his punches off then, trying to nullify, not allowing Arthur to come back with anything. Arthur needs to be taking the initiative a little bit more, I would think.
Good right hand from Cook. Just looking a little more compact in his work so far, and cleaner. And he's busy too. He's just doing that little bit more for me anyway, early on.
Yep, the better work's coming from Cook. He's using up a lot of steam. Good start on my card here, but he's using up a lot of steam and achieving that. But I think they come in here tonight planning on getting into an early lead in case weight and strength was an issue in the second half of the fight. The right hand's finding its target too. Arthur did have defensive frailties in his early days, and I don't think he's addressed them completely. Head a little bit stationary.
Round three. Third round of this one, and a pretty good start for Nicky Cook, who might have just edged the first couple of rounds. Might have. Our cards aren't the ones that matter, of course. He's in the light blue, the man from Essex, looking to become a world champion for the first time tonight. Super accurate with that jab, Cook.
Very quick with it too, stepping right in with it. I mean, he's not on the back foot, he's getting full leverage into these shots. Looking quite a bit sharper than Arthur is in the early stages here.
Arthur's jab, by comparison, not finding its target. And Cook whips in shots to head and body. He looks a man, really, who's, as the Americans like to say, brought his A game.
Yeah, he is really fired up. I mean, it's as though he's come in with a plan. He knew exactly what he hoped to achieve, and he's doing that. Whereas Arthur is the look of someone who's prepared to take things as it comes. Lovely stuff from Cook there.
Arthur's just being outboxed a little early on here, it has to be said, but he's big and strong, and he's usually found a way to prevail. And it is still early.
Well, Arthur's going to have to impose himself on Cook, because Cook, without doubt, is the sharper of the two. He's quick, his punches are snappy. So Arthur has to find a way to break his rhythm, because he's enjoying this. An excellent start from Cook.
11 days training in Tenerife, paying up on that big mountain there. And he did a full 12-rounder with former European light welterweight champion Colin Lines last Friday in preparation. That went well too, I'm told. Just can't quite get a foothold in the fight yet, Arthur. Looking a little frustrated.
Beginning to back Cook up a little bit more now. Still not finding the target. Not really taking charge. But Cook's still looking that little bit sharper, that little bit smarter. More eye-catching punches, again, coming from Cook in this round, I feel.
There is always this suspicion with Alex Arthur, though they say they had a great training camp, that he is a bit tight at this weight, 9'4".
Well, I expected several years ago that Alex's future was in the lightweight division. I'm surprised he's still at super featherweight, but obviously the 24-hour in advance weigh-in is leading towards him. I thought Cook nicked that one as well.
Keep your head moving.
Well, a close round again, Ian, but I think that the punches you remember when the bell rings are the ones that were coming from Nicky Cook. They were much more impressive.
Still time, though, for Alex Arthur. He did have an exceptionally good winner against a guy called Kova Gogolatsa, did Arthur, and he says that was as good as a world title win that night, even if he was eventually handed the title by the WBO politicians, if I can put it that way. Good right hand from Arthur over the top there.
Just landed a good left hook as well, which just steadied Cook slightly. So I'm wondering if Arthur can get some clean punches home. It looks to have the power to shake Cook up, but Cook is so quick and so quick to counter.
Just might take one moment for Alex Arthur to just turn things a little here. It's poised like that. This is a slightly better start to this session for Arthur. Probably his best half a minute in the fight so far.
Yeah, Cook's not stepping in with confident jabs here. He's popping as he backs away. Walked into one again.
And that buckled his knees. That buckled his knees a bit.
A couple of times in this round, Arthur has shown he does have the power to trouble Cook.
Cook was down five times against the American Steve Luevano in his world title shot at featherweight.
We have to remember Arthur has come out on top in a couple of shootout fights too. I mean, he has tremendous spirit, good chin, although he was over against Foster in his last fight. He's tough.
Just a little sign here in the fourth of a slight turning of the tide after a super sharp start from Cook. And he certainly buzzed Cook up with one and seemed to just bend his knees, didn't he, with it?
Yep, the first the punch that impressed me was the left hook, which seemed to steady, and then the right hand did the same. And you can see a difference in Cook's demeanour in this fight. Not stepping in with a jab, trying to counter with it now. So just a little swing in the action here. Those were good shots from Cook, though.
You can certainly put the punches together in combinations, Nicky Cook.
Just starting to wonder when the pace in this one slows, as it inevitably must. Well, it swing towards Arthur. At this moment, it's early, but he's looking a bit strong, that bit stronger.
He'd be naturally the bigger man. I'd be fascinated to know what the weights on the night were here. That's a good right hand from Cook, who's come back well in the last half minute or so of this round. But that's Alex Arthur's round, maybe the first one he's won.
Working good, perfect, working good. Fix my shots.
Corners, 10 seconds. I mean, he was shaking a couple of times in that round, so Arthur has found in that round, he does have the power to trouble Cook. And Cook just not so impressive in his own punching there.
Alex Arthur, the defending champion in the darker blue shorts from Scotland, Edinburgh to be precise. Nicky Cook, south of the border, looks to start fast and re-establish himself at the beginning of the fifth.
I thought Cook come into this fight determined to get a good start, because I was wondering, did they feel it's going to be rocky and rough in the last half of the fight? Well, we're approaching that stage, we're about to find out.
I just think the intensity level has just been turned up a notch here. We're past the feeling out stages of the fight and into the real thing here. That nice right cross. He's got a good repertoire of punches, Cook.
Yeah, a bit more mobile in this round too. Good stuff again from Cook. Much more mobile. I think maybe it's a hit and move campaign. Maybe they're going to mount for a round or so.
really is a must-win fight, this, for Nicky Cook, because he might just start to slip away from the radar of the elite levels. There wouldn't be too many more chances, maybe, if he couldn't take advantage tonight. Good left arm from Arthur, and they rock back the head of Cook.
Yeah, good body shot, they set up. Again, they're coming to the stable. Cook actually turned away from that. Well, Cook turned all the way around, away from the punch. I mean, he should maybe have had the chat from Nicky Van there.
Get the feeling at the start of this round that Cook came out looking to re-establish control, feeling he might have lost it the round before. Arthur determined that that won't happen, so this is a vital phase.
Just a couple of signs that if it becomes a toe-to-toe, that Arthur might have the advantages, but still plenty of life and the boxing and the punching of Cook. This is a close round.
Arthur may feel, and his corner may feel, that his strength, the natural man at this weight, the bigger man, and extra power might pay for him late. Might. But I've absolutely no doubt that Nicky Cook is in prime condition here. He was a picture of health at the weigh-in.
Boxing a smart fight as well, Cook. I mean, you know, it's just not the way to do it, standing and trading with Arthur, but he's standing long enough to get some authority in his punches, then getting himself back out of there, spoiling a little bit inside.
Sixth round, Alex Arthur, the Scot defending the WBO Super Featherweight Championship at 9'4". He's caught by a nice left there from challenger Nicky Cook.
Arthur's kind of walking forward in straight lines, which is a problem. When Cook get times that jab, it really is a solid-looking punch he throws.
One of the criticisms of Alex Arthur is there's not been too much head movement, not enough anyway. That's good punches. And Cook finds that target pretty easily. Arthur looks a bit disgusted with himself for taking the shots.
Yeah, and Arthur's the one who wants to tie up there. He wasn't looking to come back with counters, he was looking to tie up. So I think those punches maybe just had an effect, maybe steadied them. Good shots from Cook.
Just extra hand speed from Cook working for him, I fancy a bit, you know, in this fight. And accuracy too. He just looks slightly the better technician, but Arthur is the one maybe with more of the dig. That's the battle line. That's the strategy we have here.
Yeah, but Arthur's also the one who's chasing this, and I think he realises that he's just a little bit predictable at times. Cook is boxing a smart fight. He started off aggressively, but now he's picking his moments to put the work in.
Good counter-punching from Cook, but Arthur did get there with a couple of body shots of his own in the exchange. Just dabs away at his nose. There's a bit of blood around Nicky Cook's nose. Fascinating argument for this world championship, and it's still all there to be won and lost, you feel.
Still think Cook is producing the smarter boxing here, picking his moments to let shots go, getting himself out of there. When he gets his punches off, he's spoiling Arthur's counters. This is clever stuff from Cook.
Just that little bit of extra speed working from him. He's clipped by the left hook with those kind of raiding touches. What a great right hand from Nicky Cook, right around the temple. Arthur just holds on for a second after that. Cook's been magnificent so far, you have to say. Top class performance. Can he sustain it though? No There's the bell to end the round. Cook's round. Just a bit of damage in the other corner for Nicky Cook. Blood on the nose.
Just get him safe. He's holding the inside. Who's the champion? You're the champion, do you hear me? You're the champion.
There's some concern in that Arthur corner, I think.
Yeah, well, they know he's not performing. They know he's the one chasing it. He's a little bit too predictable, whereas Cook's using his imagination, boxing a smart fight. They're standing his ground when it's the right thing to do. They're getting off out of there. Not a lot, and the stats there. But I have Cook in a fairly comfortable lead at the halfway stage.
Yeah, I've got him 3 points up at the halfway stage, Nicky Cook.
Set out, round seven.
Here's round seven. Darker blue shorts of Alex Arthur from Edinburgh.
There you have Arthur. I've given Arthur one round and a share of another. So Cook threw 3 points up. So Arthur chasing this, but you would expect, he would imagine this is the fight coming in to his territory, the second half.
In theory, anyway.
Yeah, well, that's what you would expect. He would fancy. And I think the Cook camp have come in looking for a half-stage lead. Well, they've got it on my card.
But how does the plot twist and turn now, I wonder? Arthur, they just showed a little reluctance maybe to lead off because he's been countered a bit, hasn't he?
Yep, and he seems now to be looking for powerful shots.
Just a slip. No knockdown. Arthur grins through the gum shield rather than. But it was just a slip.
I tell you, Cook did think of it, giving him one when he was on the floor there, giving him a smack.
You know what Mickey Van always says, no naughties. I don't think he'd have stood for that. The Cook camp strategy, well thought out, working so far. Two body shots, a good right over the top, then a left hook. Look at this, Nicky Cook. Five punch combination that time. No answer from Arthur.
But these are quality shots from Cook there. Touch of class about that work. Those were hurtful punches, and I think Arthur would agree with that.
Cook was convinced going in, told anyone who'd listen, that he would be the stronger man in there of these two.
Well, that was an impressive exchange, and if you like, the one whose form seems to have dipped in this round is Alex Arthur. Weight has always been an issue with him. If he's fully strong at 9'4", fine, but if he's not, this is where it'll start showing itself. He was over in the 11th round of the Stephen Foster fight, which was a shock to me. Wonder when we start seeing those signs again. Good right.
Big coming right. Best punch so far for Arthur. That hurt Cook. He immediately grabbed hold. That was Arthur's humdinger. Cook needed a little time for his head to clear. But of course, your fitness and conditioning does help you in that kind of situation with a head to clear. But it was Arthur's best punch. He knows he's hurt him too. He's looking to follow up here, Arthur. And there's the bell. It's coming at a good time for Cook.
Wasn't a good round for Alex Arthur, but I think he got a little break just in the last few seconds because you can see he was out-punched, out-thought and out-boxed again. Then he landed that punch towards the end. And you can see the effect, one of the few clean punches that Arthur has landed tonight. And you can see the effect. That was bang on the chin, he won't catch him any cleaner. But that's exactly what Arthur would need to boost his confidence a little bit because not too much has been going right for him up to this point.
Six, seven, nine, eight.
That right hand might be grounds for encouragement for Arthur. And I hope the corner have told him that he probably has work to do here on the scorecards. We think he has anyway. Mind you, we're not always right. Good stuff from Cook, very accurate. Arthur looked a little befuddled, and he does again then. Just couldn't cope with the speed. He grins sheepishly.
Well, again, Cook comes up with the perfect answer at the perfect time. Public place from Cook, that one shoot, Arthur.
He's starting to set his feet a little more for some of these. Nicky Cook, he's not known as a big knockout puncher, but respectable enough. 16 knockouts in his 28 wins. He's been fighting at a good level most of the way too. British Commonwealth, European fights, that sort of thing. Arthur has 19 knockouts in his 26 wins.
Arthur can't seem to show the fire it's needed to get into the driving seat properly here. Cook seems to have an answer for whatever he comes up with. This is another close round.
Just get the impression with Cook too that he feels like he's made the odd dent in Arthur in this round. One danger for him might just be overconfidence. The tactics he's used so far, really he should be sustaining right through to the final bell if he can do that.
Yeah, well, I don't expect overconfidence because he has a plan. And it's been a smart performance all the way through. His concentration hasn't dipped. He's been pinned a couple of times on the end of solid right hands, but didn't do anything particularly wrong. Arthur is the one who really has to raise the pace here.
Yeah, he's been smart and cute, Cook, a lot of the time. Just imperceptible little changes of angles to whip in his shots. And then his hand speed and accuracy and general technical proficiency has done the rest for him. Of Arthur just dropping. I think he needs another of those humdingers to turn it around a bit, doesn't he, here now?
Well, good defensive boxing in this round from Cook. He hasn't been taking too many, but maybe not initiating enough either. But keeping out of harm's way, and the way I have on my card, he'll settle for this. Nice left hook from Arthur.
There's a right hand as well. From Cook, the sweat was spraying from both of them there under the arc lights for a moment.
He's trying to load up for the right hand, he's tired. He's waiting for your jab and then he's trying to load up the right hand. Fainting first, then a left hook on the top right hand, and then work the body. Yeah, he's tired. He's really tired. Like, don't let him into it, he could have stole that round. Step it up.
Round 9.
There's some talk, by the way, of Alex Arthur maybe even fighting Marco Antonio Barrera should he win this fight. But that's a big if at the moment. I've still got it to Cook by 3 points on my card.
I have a little bit wider. That one actually tightened it up there with Arthur in the last round.
Ninth round.
Just a slip.
Just a slip. There's a wet patch, you know, in the middle of the ring there. It's been a problem all night. I don't know if somebody's spilled a cup of tea or something earlier.
I think it's just the sweat towards the end, maybe, of a long night. I don't know.
I've seen some of the undercard fighters have problems with that as well. Might need to look at that. It's a bit late now. How much of a worry is that, Jim, if you're in the middle of a fight and you think a bit of the ring is like a banana skin?
I don't think it's in your mind. I mean, if it happens, then you just forget about it. All you're thinking about is the fail in front of you. Nice little two-punch burst again from Cook.
Just a feeling that Arthur needs to step this up somehow. looking for that right hand again. That was the punch that really had Cook in a bit of trouble momentarily. The bell came at quite a good time for Cook, not long after. Just look for any signs now of Cook maybe slowing up.
Arthur doesn't really look as though he's capable of taking advantage of that.
Strange to say, but the guy who's moved up and is having basically his first big fight at this weight, 9 stone 4 pound, is the one who looks most comfortable at the weight.
Yeah, but I mean, that's exactly what's happening. Nicky did tell us he had terrible trouble doing featherweight. When you're winning, you stay at the weight and you carry on because you're winning. Maybe the fact that he lost tells him it's time to step up. But he's looking good.
And this is a fighter who has really paid his dues in the business, Nicky Cook, as well. He would be a deserving world champion if he was to secure it. It would mean big money, too, for him.
Now, what you working a bit more?
Yeah. Right. Second out, round 10.
Three rounds left in this battle for the WBO Super Featherweight Championship of the World. Held currently by Alex Arthur, but if our scorecards are right, he's behind in this fight.
Yeah, but I've got him behind. I think he's been out-thought in too many of the rounds by Cook. I think Cook's there. Strategy all the way through his fight plan. He's got it to work for him. Arthur really needs a big turnaround in this.
Has Arthur got another gear? Have these punches that Cook's been spearing in the whole way through, have they left a mark? How much petrol's left in the tank?
I mean, it's time now for caution to the wind. Just do whatever's necessary to get a grip on this, and Arthur doesn't seem able to do it, doesn't seem to have the strength. We expected him to be stronger in the second half of this one. Haven't seen it.
His defence hasn't really been good enough tonight, either has it really, Arthur? His head movement is almost non-existent.
He's walking straight forward, he's been too predictable. Whereas Cook has the imagination, the speed, the changes of tempo, the changes of plan. See, the tape's coming loose now. We'll have to just stop the action for a second.
And Cook's the bandage on his glove just running loose. That has to be cut off to stop it flapping in the other fighter's eye. It's a nuisance, really. And Mickey Vance on the running repairs himself. No scissors needed, apparently. Arthur run out of ideas here, Jim?
I just don't think he has the fire in the barrel that's required. I don't want to take anything away from Nicky Cook's performance. It's been excellent. But I've always had doubts about Arthur. At 9 stone 4, he's been grinding out performances. But the way he collapsed in the 11th round in his last fight, and the way he's just a little bit flat and a little bit slow in getting the punches off.
Always the superior work rate from Nicky Cook most of the way through this. That's how it's looked to us, anyway. Maybe the judges are seeing something different.
Yeah, but any time you've raised off your seat or what you remember at the end of the rounds, it's usually what Nicky Cook's been doing. I mean, it's been bright, it's been sharp. Whereas Alex has always had the look of someone who's trying to force his way into this fight.
I think it's been a magnificent performance, this, from Nicky Cook. I really do. Arthur needs to find some answers, otherwise his world title might be going out of the window. Good body shots in there for Arthur.
But again, Cook's quite happy to stay there and answer back.
And there's not much fire being spat out, really, by Arthur at this stage. He almost has the air of somebody who's either just run out of ideas or he's kind of accepted the situation. It looks like that.
Just don't think he has the energy, Ian. It's not there.
You've got 6 minutes, right?
How delighted they must be in the cook corner. Now, let's see what Wayne McCulloch has to say.
Come straight back.
OK. Ooh.
All right.
Drink spot on.
Oh, it's a good one.
Give me some faith. Just go, you've got three more.
See, again, the quality punches that you remember when the bell rings are the ones thrown by Nicky Cook. I think his battle plan has been carried out to perfection. He's known when to stand and mix, he's known when to back off, when to slip and slide. Stats have it close, but Cook well in front.
Yeah, me too, Jim. And I think Nicky Cook might be a little bit surprised.
Round 11.
It's become a little bit of an easy ride for him. Here's round 11 here. The lighter blue trunks of Nicky Cook of Dagenham. What might be his finest hour. And with Dad in his corner too as the trainer, they devised the strategy. They watched the videos of Arthur. They thought out what they were going to do. They've gone in the ring and they've done it. So far, yeah, anyway.
Right from the opening bell, you can see they had a plan and Cook has stuck with it. And he's never been knocked out of it. Arthur never been able to totally take the initiative away from him.
Has to guard against carelessness now. Cook's just remained pretty busy all the way through. Arthur has to somehow seize the initiative, unless somehow in his mind he thinks that he's leading in this fight. Could he think that?
I don't think so. Looking at his face in the corner, hearing what he's saying, I think I heard him saying, give me a bit of faith. I think he knows it's a struggle, it's not working for him, he's not producing. A lot of close rounds. But Cook always seems to be the one who impresses you. Good shot there from Arthur.
Needs more of that though, a lot more. Needs a real grandstand finish. I think one of the other things that's troubling really for Arthur is he seems to have had a lot of trainers in his career. There seems to be a lot of chopping and change. We've got Wayne McCulloch in here for the first time for this one.
Yeah, and it takes time to gel, and I think he's pretty set in his ways. I don't think he's going to learn anything from new trainers, anything drastic. I think it's just a case of getting him in the best of condition. But there's always that weight issue at the back of my mind. But this is better from him.
He's looking to get at Cook here and unload some big ones, and he needs them too, because it might be irretrievable on the scorecard by normal means. Cook, look at him just change the angle, darting this way and that. Every time Arthur tries to get set, he's on his bike, he's on the balls of his feet. He may think he has enough points in the bag here and just has to stay upright. He's got a little negative here for a moment, Cook. And he's caught by an uppercut. That lifts the crowd. It might have lifted Arthur too. It was a good shot from the Scot.
I don't think you get the full power behind it, but it knocked Cook's head up in the air, maybe just disorientated him a little bit. So Arthur has to pile on and make that pay. Good work now from Arthur. He's been around for a long time.
Yeah, and I just think Cook has just gone to sleep mentally a little for the first time in the fight in this round. Just started, the mind has started to wander. That could be tiredness, who knows.
Listen to your dad.
Keep that going. Keep your jab going and keep your hands up while you've got one more round. Yeah. And what he does to you when you get inside, just get in there, work, and then claim him again. Yeah. Why keep inside? You, when you're walking back there with your tire, he's catching
you. Focus. You're the world champion, do you hear me? You are.
Top man.
You're the world champion, do you hear me? You're the world champion.
You are the world champion.
Go out there and finish this fight like a world champion.
Raise me up.
Go out there and finish this fight.
Raise me up in glory.
Watch for his right hand.
Just 20 more minutes. Yeah. Right? But you've got to work. I want you to win the round.
Yeah.
Right? As you go, eat me that jab all the time. Bang, bang, bang. Eat your man there. Do what you've got to do.
Yeah.
And then you claim it.
Get him out of there. You can.
A lot of urgency in the corner. Wayne McCulloch saying to Arthur, you're the world champion. Go out and prove it in this round. But Arthur, I don't know. His mind doesn't seem to be there.
there. He seems to be asking for religious inspiration. He is a very religious young man, but he's been talking about faith and inspiration. I think he knows better than anyone. This has been a struggle from him from start to finish.
He's been speaking a lot to Cook in quite a friendly sort of way. He did at the end of the last round, and he had quite a lot to say to him at the start of this round. And I just wonder if it was along the lines of, he's looked like he's almost accepted the situation, that Cook's just been the better man tonight.
See, I say he is very religious, and I think he is a true sportsman. I saw him at the weigh-in yesterday, cuddling Michael Gomez, to whom he suffered that real heavy defeat. I think he's a real sportsman. A beautiful punch from Cook.
And remember, tonight is a kind of holy grail for Nicky Cook. And what a performance he's put up here. Has Arthur just got one last dramatic punch? Or is he spent? Is he out of ideas, out of inspiration?
Well, you couldn't blame Cook for coasting, because he must feel he's in front. He wouldn't want to be taking any chances this late. But he's not carrying on with the same tactics. Maybe a little bit more negative than we've seen him, but that's sensible.
If Cook wins this, does he get the fight with Amir Khan or Marco Antonio Barrera for a lot of money?
I think that fight would still be there for Arthur if he loses, because I think maybe he'll finally admit his future lies at lightweight.
Yeah, maybe, despite everything they said in the build-up, he's lost the battle with the scales. Too tight at the weight. He's fought a little bit like that tonight, you'd have to say.
But don't want to take anything whatsoever away from Nicky Cook. I think it's been an outstanding performance. But you do have to say there was something missing from Alex Arthur's boxing tonight.
He's just not been allowed in the fight. It's been a superb display of technical skills from Cook. A beautifully thought-out strategy, expertly executed, as Arthur is made to miss, and it's the story of the fight. Cook, so confident now, turns him on the ropes, powers home the punches, and he must feel so good in there after all the struggles through the career, the long hours in the gym. This is what a fighter dreams about, becoming a world champion. Nothing's concrete yet, though. It has to be confirmed by the judges first, but on our scorecards, Cook surely is a runaway winner of this.
Yeah, Arthur's done a lot of chasing in the last round. You can't blame Cook, maybe, for just coming off the pedal, just looking for that final bell. Because he and his corner must feel this is in the bag for them. Just don't go out and blow it. And that's how his boxing has looked in the final round.
It's all over. The two of them embracing the centre of the ring. It's always like that, even a kiss between them. Mutual admiration, mutual respect. But Nicky Cook looked a big and impressive winner of that. And it could be his crowning night. In fact, Wayne McCulloch is just tapping him on the back, as almost as if to acknowledge it before the decision's announced, Jim.
Yeah, and I think the verbals we were getting from the Arthur corner about, you know, looking for inspiration, give me faith. I mean, he knew what he was doing, you know, in a boxing sense, wasn't working. He was losing, and I think he's accepted that. But Nicky Cook, from start to finish, I must say, wonderful performance.
A long conversation afterwards. You'd love to be able to eavesdrop on that, wouldn't you? Okay. Here it comes officially now.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 amazing rounds, we have a unanimous decision. Judge Francis scores the contest 112 to 117. Judge Parrish scores the contest 111 to 117. Judge O'Connor scores the contest 114, 115. The winner and the new WBO Super Featherweight Champion of the World,
Moment, crowning moment from Nicky Cook. He thoroughly deserved it. How Terry O'Connor only had 1 point in it is quite another question. But brilliant performance, Nicky Cook.
What an absolutely ecstatic, absolutely over the moon. You don't realise what this means to me. It means so much for my family. I can hopefully secure them there, buy our ass out of it, and have my little daughter and my little baby boy was coming in 2 weeks' time, and hopefully I can secure their future a bit.
You've worked so hard for this. You've trained, you had your ups and downs, but yeah. Tactically, you seem to get it spot on tonight, moving, yeah. Using your speed to outfox him.
Yeah, me and Dad, we had a great game plan. I mean, we did it for 12 rounds non-stop. We'll walk away with the belt. It was like educated boxing with him, but also not flying around the ring, but just keeping an arm's distance and just letting the punches go out of arm's reach. And it worked, and it worked a treat. My father, we've been working bloody hard for this for 12 weeks and it's all paid off.
Lovely respect between the two of you at the end. What did he say to you?
He's a great guy. Alex is going to come down. We're going to exchange numbers. I'm going to buy him a beer after this. We're going to exchange numbers. Next week he's going to come down to London, see my family with his family, and we're going to go out for a nice meal.